I'm aware that I just made a video a few days ago with the same title and the same thumbnail talking about Jalen Smith and his impressive showings. And then he gets into foul trouble, he has to deal with a tough matchup with Jonas Valanciunas, we see Bismack Biyombo, and suddenly Biyombo has put together a case to be the Suns' second best center on their roster, potentially their backup guy during the playoffs, and just a fantastic game he had against the Pelicans tonight. He had 16 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists, 2 steals, 3 blocks, he's a plus 8, and he just made so many great plays down the stretch closing out the game on both offense and defense. I mean, the offense, it's pretty easy stuff, I think. As long as you got Chris Paul on the court and you're just rolling hard to the rim, you're gonna get those buckets. But it was Bismack doing it, you know? You gotta give him credit. He was the guy who was out there doing it. And on defense, man, he was just using that crazy length and great shot timing to block some shots and make great plays down the stretch. Bismack Biyombo was probably the most important player on the court for the Suns closing out that game. And, man... I'm impressed. He's definitely going to be getting a roster spot, if not tonight. Like, that would be crazy if they signed a free agent immediately after the game. I think it'll probably be tomorrow the Suns will announce their official signing of Bismack Biyombo, because it is simply inevitable at this point. This guy's been with the team for 4 days, and he's had 2 great performances. One against the Hornets, where I think he had 11 points, 3 rebounds, and like a steal and a block as well, and an assist. And then tonight, having another great night. Like, Bismack Biyombo has certainly earned a roster spot very, very quickly. And, yeah, that leaves the Suns in a very sticky situation, which is what we have to talk about for the rest of the video, I think. Which is that they would have 6 centers under contract if this contract thing does go through with Bismack Biyombo, 2 of which are currently injured for the long term. Well, I don't know how much more long-term, because both of them were projected to come back during the next 2 months or so, but both Dario Saric and Frank Kaminsky have been hurt for quite a bit now. And then we also have, of course, Jalen Smith, JaVale McGee, and DeAndre Ayton, along with, presumably, Bismack Biyombo. That's 6 centers on the roster, and you've got to think the Suns are going to do something about it. Like, you've got to clear some of these centers out. They're all fantastic human beings, and it sucks. But we're going to have to get rid of the center somehow, whether it's Jalen Smith being packaged together with Dario Saric in a big trade, or maybe they decide they want to hold on to Jalen Smith for the time being, and they decide to dump both Saric and Kaminsky's contracts to acquire some more guard talent, or just dump their contracts in general and, you know, maybe try to send some players via waivers or make other trades, maybe trade picks for players, that sort of thing. With open roster spots. We'll see what the Suns choose to do, but I can't imagine we're just going to stick around with all 6 centers on the roster, and yeah, that doesn't make sense at this point, especially with 2 of those players not being healthy, and the Suns having a pretty obvious need at the guard position. Just with Shamet struggling, Cameron Payne's been struggling a bit. He did have a good night tonight, though. Actually, 4 points, 2 for 7 from the field. I might have spoke too soon. 5 assists, 1 turnover is pretty good, though. Minus 8. Payne, you know, we're definitely good with Booker, Chris Paul, and Cameron Payne. He'll be a lot better, you know. He's just not quite in rhythm at the moment. But Landry Shamet has been really out of whack, and Elfrid Payton has just been downright disgusting on the offensive end. He really doesn't do much for us, and Suns could really use a guy in his position who can play defense, shoot the catch and shoot 3, but also be able to create off the dribble, and do more than just create off the dribble, like do point guard type stuff, like we've seen Shamet do at times, where they're calling pick and rolls, they've got to take men off, they got to take their guy off the dribble, that sort of thing, and yeah, I don't know where the Suns really look to acquire a guy like that. Do you go for a high talent guy like maybe a Caris LeVert and do something crazy like that? Trade for Caris LeVert, maybe trade for a lower tier guy like an Ish Smith or maybe a Hall Nato. Both of those guys, former Wizards point guards. I mean, Smith has played with the Suns, I believe. So we could see him back. He did play, I can't quite remember at the moment. I wasn't watching the Suns when he played, I'll say that. I wasn't watching basketball when he played. At all, so anyways, Sun should be looking to acquire some more guard depth because it kind of sucks at the moment. And Justin Jackson wasn't cutting it. Alfred Payton really wasn't cutting it. So, yeah, I would like to see some improvement there. But I was happy to see Ish Wainwright have a pretty darn good game. I mean, 3 points, 2 assists, 2 rebounds, 1 steal. He had a 3. It wasn't anything that's really jumping off the page, but I think he made a lot of winning plays. But it might have also just been a good matchup for him, being just like a really strong dude going up against Jonas Valanciunas and helping boxing out and helping secure defensive rebounds. Sometimes, you know, you just don't get credit for the defensive rebounds just because you're boxing out. Someone else collects it, that sort of thing. I think Wainwright did that quite a bit when he's on the court. There's a lot of times where Wainwright was able to help create possessions where we could push the pace and that would lead to like a transition bucket. I think that noticeably happened a lot more with Wainwright on the court. And it happened regardless if he was at the 5 or the 4, like playing small ball 5 or at the 4. He's also very high into the positive during his time at the small ball 5. So that's something interesting to think about, but I don't know if we really want to lean into him as a small ball center as the season goes on. I would really prefer, you know, like a Jay Crowder at small ball center, or we find someone who's a little bit better to play a small ball center. But anyways, Jalen Smith struggles once again. I mean, dealing with Jonas Valanciunas, you know, one of those top 3 strongest guys in the league, maybe top 4, maybe Zion's ahead of him. I'd say Giannis, Zion, Steven Adams, and Mr. Jonas Valanciunas are all in that conversation for the strongest player in the league. And Jalen Smith, honestly, he didn't really totally struggle because Valanciunas bullies everyone. It was kind of just the referees giving him a very bad whistle, and then Bismack Biyombo coming in and then really outperforming him in those opportunities Biyombo did get. So that's why we never saw Jalen Smith back on the court after a very productive first quarter. I think he had 7 points before he checked out. He hit 2 threes in the night, 2 for 3 from 3. That's going to push up his 3-point percentage because it was pretty low before. And yeah, he's only looking better as time goes on. Let's be honest, like, he is maturing at an unreal rate. Like, it's clear this man's going to be very, very good. It's just a question of where do the Suns want to go with their centers. This is probably the least consequential, but, you know, some of the most difficult decisions James Jones is going to have to make during his time as general manager, deciding who do we keep and who do we move on from in the center group. You know, let's completely get rid of that tag of inconsequential. No, it is consequential. You know, it is a big deal because you're deciding who's going to be on your roster coming into playoff time. Do you have faith that all these guys can stay healthy, or would you rather keep this step at the center position? Do you want to go 5 strong at center for whatever reason? Or do you want to cut it down to 4 center so we can stack our depth at other positions like wing and guard, which are clearly lacking for this roster, if you ask me? I mean, the center position is really set, but yeah, it's an interesting thought going forward. I think I have 2 more things to talk about, which is, first of all, Mark Ryans has been fantastic with the centers, but tonight, I mean, Bismack Biyombo is just being an extremely talented NBA player. The only reason he hadn't been in the league is because he is grieving the death of his father, which, yeah, I mean, that's a completely understandable situation. Really high character guy in Bismack Biyombo, struggling with loss, and yeah, you know, he comes back, decides to join the Suns for his first stint back, and he's been extremely impressive. Like, he would have certainly been in the league if it wasn't for these other circumstances. And the Suns, you know, they stumbled upon a guy who's, you know, a really fantastic player in the right situation, especially when you're playing alongside a great point guard like Chris Paul. It allows you to, you know, go to other areas of your game and, you know, do other things at a higher level because you have Chris Paul supporting you so much at the point guard position. And that's exactly what Bismack Biyombo did tonight. And yeah, I would be extremely surprised if he wasn't around for the long run. Now, let's finally touch on the last video I made, talking about Jalen Smith and DeAndre Ayton. And a few people presented potentially playing Jalen Smith at the center position with DeAndre Ayton at the power forward position as a potential circumstance, potential circumstance in which the Suns could potentially play both Styx and Aiden together, and it would make sense to sign Styx long term because those two players would work well together. And the answer is, which I didn't really talk about in my comments and responding to those comments, is that I simply don't know at this point. The thing is that the Suns really don't have like a set in stone way of running a two big set at this point. But the thing is that I have a whole theory that I'm putting together, and it's going to be a video, and it's going to be, I think it's going to be a pretty cool video where I'm going to talk about how two center lineups are really, really fantastic in the league right now. It might be the key to cracking the NBA Finals and winning it all, and how a lot of the other teams who have won NBA Finals have actually done the same thing, running these two center lineups, and it's working, and it's, you know, it is the key to being a successful NBA team. So, just looking at the Suns, I mean, I think Jae Crowder works really well in our current offensive scheme as a fantastic wing player. But if we're being real, like, as I said, there's a clear correlation, or I will, you know, make a full video about this, but there is a clear correlation between teams who run these two big lineups, you know, these two untraditional wings, two untraditional bigs, well, two not modern bigs, let's say that. Like, one, you know, kind of standard big, which would be DeAndre Ayton in this case. And then we would have Jalen Smith, a more mobile big, as our other big. And it's kind of defying this mobile, or this, not mobile, this kind of modern idea of playing small ball players, playing like a small ball wing at the four, kind of like Jae Crowder, and then playing a floor spacer at the five, or more mobile guy at the five, kind of like, you know, the Heat with Bam Adebayo, or maybe a Karl-Anthony Towns with the Timberwolves, who's out on the three-point line all the time. And it's kind of defying those ideas, and I think it's really, like, there's a clear correlation here that have a better NBA team, you want to have two big guys in the court. And I think this could be the case, but we have no evidence at this point. And all we have is conjecture. And someone was clipping or showing me a clip of Bruno Fernando playing alongside Jalen Smith in Jalen Smith's freshman season at Maryland, which is a really interesting thing to think about, because that is kind of the case. Like, at that time, Smith was a mobile four, and then we saw Bruno Fernando, obviously a center at this point. I don't even know, is he in the league right now? I think he might have gotten cut by the Celtics, I'm not sure, but we saw those guys play together at Maryland, and, you know, it kind of worked. They made some noise in the tournament. I think they were the sixth seed or something, and Maryland was decent that year from what I remember. But yeah, I have some doubts without any evidence of how good these two center, you know, situations will be for the Suns. And yeah, honestly, I don't know at this point. It's as simple as that. But the main issue is that the Suns have to actually put together a two-center lineup, which, it's not just like, okay, we're actually going to put two centers onto the court at the same time. It's more like, you have to have a whole offensive game plan prepared for when you do put two centers on the court. Because our current offensive system is very schematically reliant upon, you know, that center running around in the inside, and no one else stays inside. Like, you always have four guys spaced out, and then the center is mainly the only ones spacing or running around setting screens. The other four guys space out, and, you know, if the center isn't setting screens, he's, you know, sitting in the dunker spot or sitting kind of near the three-point line. How does it work when you have both Styx and Aiden on the court? Well, that's when you have to, you know, think of a new scheme, and you have to put something together where, you know, one player is going to be operating high, setting screens. The other player is going to be sitting in the dunker spot and setting some off-ball screens. Like, there's a whole lot of imagining which will have to go into putting together a two-center lineup. And I don't know if the Suns want to go that direction at this point. I honestly don't. I couldn't tell you. I'm not in the Suns organization. I don't know. And maybe they are planning to do something like that. But I just don't know. And we'll see what happens, but yeah, maybe they will. It would be pretty crazy to see them do that, and I think it can work really well. But yeah, two centers can work. Two centers can really work. Look at what the Bucks were doing. Look at what the Cavs are doing right now. Look at what, like, even the Grizzlies are doing right now. Like, Jaren Jackson isn't an extremely good three-point shooter, but they still make it work with him and Steven Adams. Like, there's ways to make two big lineups work. The Golden State Warriors, man, they run out of starting lineup of Draymond Green and Kevon Looney every single game. Like, you ever think about that? They're still extremely successful. Like, there's ways to make this work, and the Suns can do it. Like I really believe they can make this work if they try. And it's really a question of if they try. Well, okay. I won't put my 100% faith that it will work, but I'm saying there's a considerable possibility that it can work. We just don't know at this point. There's nothing that can tell us either way. So I think that's about it. Thanks for watching the video. If you made it all the way to the end and you aren't already subscribed, please consider hitting subscribe. A smaller channel and every subscriber really counts. And yeah, if you made it all the way to the end and you aren't already subscribed, please consider hitting subscribe. Because you probably want to see more of my content and more Suns content. So hitting subscribe is the best way to do that. Anyways, that's it. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.